Hey guys, welcome to Coding After 30. In this video, I want to talk about starting your portfolio and the biggest misconception where you have to build it yourself from scratch. The truth is, I wouldn't recommend this approach, especially when you're starting out. When I started out, I didn't know where to get started. I did not have the skill to build website, let alone showcase my portfolio on it. And what that led me to do is to wait before I finally got to my portfolio because I felt like I needed to get enough confidence to build it. But if you're looking to get hired quickly, what you need to do, you just need to set up a beautiful themed portfolio project site to which when you build your portfolio pieces, you could add them to that. And that's what I want to talk about in this video. By the way, if you're new to this channel, my name is Paul and I talk about switching careers late in life. If this is something that interests you, consider subscribing. Now, like I said before, when you want to get hired, the three most important things you need to do. You need to know how to code. You need to have an excellent portfolio that will take time to build. And number three, you have to prepare for interviews. And that's basically it, right? And that's already too much. So when you're starting out, try to spend a lot of time spinning your wheels to set up a basic portfolio to showcase what you're working on is not the best use of your time. So what I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna show you a place where you could get some beautiful themes and you could set them up for your portfolio. And as you build your portfolio projects, you could add them to that website. And the beauty of it, your website is gonna work, it's gonna look nice, and any potential employer that is looking at your website, they're going to be impressed. They're not gonna say who made this or who did not make this. They're gonna see that in your portfolio projects, your resume, and when you get to the interview. But the most important part as you're starting out is making sure that you're doing the things that help you to get to your job faster than slower. So with that being said, I'm also gonna show you some of the things that I'm working on and give you some great ideas and a quick roadmap of what you should put into your portfolio once you set it up. So with that being said, let's jump onto my computer and take a look. Look how beautiful this website looks like. Now, this is a static website and this is perfectly fine. You don't have to spend a lot of money to get it. It's, I believe this portfolio, it's only 14 bucks and you could get it on a website called ThemeForest. So this is ThemeForest, a lot of great websites you could find and you just Google personal portfolio. And here's the website we're looking at. It's $14. It's a static website, really easy to host on Netlify. You know what I'm going to do? I'm actually going to purchase this right now and I'm going to, in the next video, show you how to set it up, how to deploy it, and you guys will have a portfolio ready to go. So subscribe so you guys don't miss that video. But look how awesome it looks. All you need is a home section here, which showcases a little bit about you, have ability to download your resume and some basic ideas, featured works. Yeah, these are stock photos, what have you. You will replace this with links to your portfolio. For web design, that's very creative dance, but for web design, that's probably not appropriate. Then we have our news where you could add articles. Now, because this is a static website, you would physically write this HTML in your code. Nothing wrong with that. And then you have your contact. You could hook up this form with Netlify and potential employers will be able to contact you and give you a job. So notice how this is a very beautiful portfolio and the goal is for you to guys get started because now you have a website which associated to your name. You could share it on LinkedIn and as you build better portfolios, you could add them to your resume. Here's another one, good one. Again, 14 bucks for a static website. Very easy to start, very easy to do. And I'm not saying you shouldn't build projects for your portfolio. What I'm saying is that you should start with a portfolio that looks professional. I mean, look how good this is. It has about me section. Not sure about how I feel about this design, but you guys could edit it. And you have a portfolio to add your portfolios. I really like this one screen layout. And you don't have to worry much about it. You just set it up. And then as you build your portfolio pieces, you could add them. One thing that I want to say, you have to understand that your goal is to get hired. And the best thing you could do is not waste time by spinning your wheels. Think of your portfolio website that you buy here for $14 as like an extension of your business card. It is your business card. You want to have your contact information. You want to have a place or a placeholder for where you could put your portfolio once you build projects that you're proud to showcase. And it's something that you could start sharing right away. It should be your domain name, should be your name. For me, it would be my first name and last name.com. And that's something I could start sharing on LinkedIn and building, and at least showing others that I'm interested into breaking into this field. Now, when you are building your portfolio, there's right projects and there's wrong projects. If you're starting out and you're younger, you could try to do whatever you want. For me, being older, I can't afford to waste time. I'm 41 years old, and the most important thing that I could do is make sure that I do only the things that help me get hired. There's many different ways that you could get hired. You could be an ASP.NET C# developer. I did it as a front-end React developer, and now I started learning back-end. So the type of websites that you wanna put in your portfolio are not little, you know, silly games, unless you're building games as a game developer. But if you're doing web design, you need to put things that you would build yourself. A first simple project could be your portfolio and blog website. Now, the reason I didn't tell you to build it from scratch and just buy a template here is because they're not as easy as they look. And by the time you build that website, it might take you much longer than anticipated. So don't wait, set up a basic website to which you could add the portfolio. And once you finish this one, you could add it. So your goal for your first portfolio, to be able to build the website based on the layout that you saw. So I did not create this layout. I actually found this layout on ThemeForest. I took a bunch of screenshots, and then I worked off the screenshots to develop this website. So I coded all the HTML, all the CSS. What I did not do is create this design from scratch, meaning I did not go into Adobe XD or Figma and worked on creating this design. Because if you're not a web designer and you're a web developer, that's not gonna be your job. As a web developer, your job is going to be getting a design in Photoshop or Figma and working off the mockup the web designers created and being able to rewrite that in HTML, CSS with JavaScript, or rewrite it and translate their design into a functional React application. So I just showed you a very simple website that you could start building for your first project. And what I would do after I finish this website, I would add it to my portfolio website. But more importantly, I'm not waiting to get started. So with that being said, once you build your basic HTML and CSS website, where do you go from there? Next, you wanna showcase your understanding and mastery of JavaScript. So what I would do is take that same HTML and CSS design that I just showed you and add some basic functionality. Once you add basic JavaScript functionality, that website is gonna showcase that you understand how to write HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. After that first project is done, you're ready to move on to your third project. Your third project is gonna showcase your ability to show that you know one of the popular frameworks, if that's the way you're looking to get a job. In my case, it was with React.js. So once I finished my static website with JavaScript, I took it and I completely redone it with React.js. So that was my third project. Project number four, this is where things are gonna get interested. What I want you to do next is take that same website we did, and the reason why I said same is because I don't want you to build things from scratch and build a couple of simpler projects. I want you to keep adding complexity and add a blog section, a way for you guys to be able to log into the website and be able to add and delete posts. So this will require you guys using an API to connect to, where you could store your blog or the data from your website on some sort of server. Now, I'm not saying to create the backend yourself. I'm gonna jump into my computer and show you in a minute what I like to use for my backend. And this is something I'm also gonna show you how to do in my later videos, because when you're first starting out, instead of trying to learn full stack right away, while you're learning the front end portion of web development, using something like Strapi will save you a lot of time and slowly teach you about what it's like to work with APIs and backend, which is something that you will eventually do. And your final project, project number five, will be something more complex. It could be something like the bug tracker. I say bug tracker a lot because that's what Coder Foundry recommended for their first project. And you know what? It's recognizable. Everybody that's gonna hire you for development knows what that is. And more importantly, it's very complex because you have different users. You will have to have authentication. You will have to create different tickets that you should be able to create, read, update, and delete. And that project is going to take you some time to build. But what I would say, after these five projects, you will have necessary skills to be able to get hired. and the same portfolio that you bought before as a placeholder. Now you could put all those five portfolio projects in there and you could confidently start preparing for the interview. So with that being said, let me show you actually my blog that I'm building now. And the reason why I'm doing it now instead of a year and a half ago before I got hired is because something like this was too much for me to do at the time and I wouldn't be able to know how to do it. So imagine waiting a year and a half to learn the necessary skill to build this website that could be my portfolio site. And that would be a year and a half that I went without any website to show. And that's why I keep telling you guys, just buy a nice theme on ThemeForest, set it up as your portfolio, and then as you build things, add them to that site. More importantly, the first few projects you're gonna make, they're not gonna be great. They are going to be sucky. I know this because my projects were sucky. And it was maybe my fourth or fifth project that I felt was good enough for employers to take me seriously. And you'll be able to replace those. But imagine building your first portfolio website that you're gonna use as your personal portfolio to host stuff, and it's not that good. It's just not gonna look nice to people checking out your portfolio. This is going to be my final website when I finish it and build it. It's going to be a blog. It's going to have ability for me to set up appointments. It's going to showcase the events that I'm hosting on my live streams. But more importantly, we'll have a dashboard section that's going to keep my students to be able to take my online courses. So it's a big project. With that being said, not only do you have to know HTML and CSS. Now, what I do want to add here, and it's because I'm following my own advice, even though I'm coding this website in Next.js myself, for my theming, I'm using Tailwind CSS to make this website look beautiful. And what you guys could do, you could use something like Bootstrap. You don't have to spin your wheels to try to recreate something from scratch. As you could see, this is going to be a nice clean portfolio. It has the section of the things that I do. It has my work experience at a glance. You have the ability to go to my resume. I also have a form. You'll be able to leave me a message. And then I also have my blog. And other features that I added here is my event section, where you're able to add events. Right now, I'm just testing. The cool thing here, this website, I'm not creating the backend from scratch. I'm using Strapi. And what Strapi allows me to do is to create content type, and I'm able to serve it on the server and connect to it from my front end. So for instance, I want to add an event here. Now I already have a draft here, so it doesn't matter what I type here, but notice how I'm able to add the information, hit publish. And now when I go to my website and refresh, and now you see my event here. So notice how I don't have to focus too much on the back end. I'm able to focus finishing the front end project. Now, once this project is done and everything works, nobody's saying that I can't afterwards create my own backend, but there's no reason for it. This is going to be my portfolio website. I'm using Strapi as my backend. It's a really good service. So I know I'm talking all over the place today, but here's the thing I want to say. The takeaway here is that you need to start building presence online and on LinkedIn. So instead of waiting till you get the confidence to build your portfolio, start with the theme that you purchase, set everything up, put your information, and as you build those awesome portfolio projects, add them to your website. And this is the best and easiest way to get started, because at the end of the day, no one's gonna care. They only wanna know is that you know how to code and your website looks good. You could leave whatever comments you guys like. I'd love to hear from you guys. We could start a discussion, but believe me when I tell you, if you have option between wasting time and being efficient and effective, which one would you guys take? By the way, with that being said, thank you so much for putting up with this video. It's been a while since I made a video. I've been doing mostly live, but I have a lot of cool content coming up, and I am going to show you in the next couple of videos how to set up a static website from the theme that we're going to purchase. I'm actually going to purchase this beautiful theme that you guys see here, and we're going to do it together. So with that being said, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Why, Paul? You gotta make better videos. Oh wait, we're still recording.